Hello students, now today we are going to discuss about importance of sanitation and hygiene in foods. Under this chapter, we are going to cover about the importance of sanitation, that is kitchen hygiene, employee hygiene and health, and food plant hygiene. The provision of safe water and sanitation is one of the key to break the cycle of poverty. Promoting hygiene not only contributes to improved health outcomes, but is a crucial factor in the sustainability of water and sanitation programs. Unhygienic behavior has a tremendous impact on human health and development. Hygiene promotion encourages people to replace their unsafe hygiene practices with simple, safe alternatives. First, we will discuss about importance of kitchen hygiene. In the kitchen hygiene, safe storage practices includes avoiding cross-contamination. Cross-contamination happens when germs from raw or unclean food get into foods that are ready to serve or that will not be cooked again before you serve them. Foods should be kept safe from cross-contamination. Raw meat, fish and poultry ought to be stored on the lower shelves of the refrigerator. Raw meats, lamb, fish or poultry are not to be dripped onto the foods that will not to be cooked before serving. Separate out different types of raw meat from each other, and unwashed food or raw food is to be stored away from ready to eat food. Wash hands between handling raw meat and foods that will not be cooked before eating. And you should never store foods that will not be cooked before serving in the same container as raw meat, fish or poultry. Wash hands before working with food and before wearing gloves. Use utensils or disposable gloves to work with ready-to-eat food. Wash, rinse and sanitize the cutting surface and all the utensils and knives every time after finishing with a job or between preparing different foods. One should use clean utensils instead of hands for dispensing food. Store foods away from cleaners and poisons. In the kitchen, use of detergents and sanitizers is must. While using detergents and sanitizers, first of all, everybody should know the directions for using chemicals. Read the labels regarding when to use them and how much to use. Keep chemicals away from food and clean utensils. If chemicals must be stored in the same room, be sure that they are stored in their own area or space. The area should be below food and utensils so that there is no chance of chemicals splashing onto food and utensils. Another way to prevent cross-contamination is to be sure that utensils, work surfaces and equipment are washed, rinsed and sanitized between uses. They are to be washed in hot soapy water and they should be rinsed in clean hot water. Sanitize them with freshly prepared sanitizer, that is 1 to 2 teaspoons of bleach per 1 gallon of water. To correct steps for cleaning utensils, food contact surfaces and equipment are to be used 3 processes. One is washing, second one is rinsing and third one is sanitizing. Food employees with dirty hands and dirty fingernails may contaminate the food being prepared. Any activity that may have contaminated the hands must be followed by thorough hand washing. Now we will learn about hand washing procedure. Many employees in the food industries fail to wash their hands as often as necessary, and even those who do may use a poor technique. It takes vigorous rubbing with soap in running water for about 20 seconds to loosen soil and illness causing organisms. Many diseases transferred through food may be harbored in the employee's intestinal tract and drop in the feces. Proper hand washing after a bowel movement establishes a barrier against the transfer of organisms present in the feces. Now we learn about hand sanitizers. Sanitizer dips or hand sanitizers are not approved hand wash techniques and are not acceptable substitutes in hand washing. And now we learn about hygiene of fingernails. The requirement for fingernails to be trimmed, filed, and maintained addresses the ability to clean beneath the fingernails. Failure to remove fecal material from beneath the fingernails after a bowel movement can be a major source of illness causing organisms. Ragged fingernails may harbor harmful microorganisms. Then jewelry. Items of jewelry such as rings, bracelets and watches may act as a hiding place for foodborne illness causing microorganisms. An additional hazard associated with jewelry is the possibility that pieces of the item or the whole item itself may fall into the food being prepared. Hard foreign objects in food may cause medical problems for consumers such as chipped and or broken teeth and internal cuts and lesions of the employees. There are several steps which will help in preventing foodborne illness by safe handling food in the home. Always wash hands with warm soapy water for 20 seconds before and after handling food, after using the toilets or bathroom, after changing a diaper, after handling pets, after attending to a sick person at home, and after blowing nose, coughing or sneezing, after handling uncooked eggs or raw meat, poultry or fish, etc. If hands have any kind of skin abrasion or infection, always use clean disposable gloves. Wash hands, gloved or not, with warm soapy water. Thorough washing of surfaces that come in contact with foods with hot soapy water before moving on to the next step in food preparation is to be done. To keep cutting boards clean, wash them in hot soapy water after each use, then rinse and air or pat dry with clean paper towels. Cutting boards can be sanitized with a solution of 1 tablespoon unscented liquid chlorine bleach per gallon of water. The surface should be flooded with the bleach solution and should be allowed to stand for several minutes. Then should be rinsed and air or pat dried with clean paper towels. Once cutting boards become excessively worn or develop hard to clean grooves, should be replaced. Do not use the same platter or utensils that held the raw product to serve the cooked product. Any bacteria present in the raw meat or juices can contaminate the safely cooked product. Serve cooked products as clean plates using clean utensils and clean hands. When using a food thermometer in the food industries, it is important to wash the probe after each use with hot soapy water before reinserting it into a food. Pets, household cleaners and other chemicals should be kept away from food and surfaces used for food. And soapy clothes ought to be packed for cleaning surfaces and hands. There are certain important safe food handling practices. Safe food handling practices are the ones most likely to preserve food's peak quality. Keeping hot foods hot and cold foods cold inhibits growth of the microorganisms that can spoil food or cause illness. Storage at the proper temperature also retains fresh appearance, pleasant aroma, and agreeable texture. Thawing meat and poultry products at room temperature and partial cooking are examples of practices which can seem like good ideas, but that may actually encourage bacterial growth by keeping food in the danger zone, 40 to 140 degree Fahrenheit temperature, where bacteria multiply fastest. And next we will learn about the importance of employee health and hygiene, especially personal hygiene. Good personal hygiene is essential to ensure food safety. That is, personal hygiene of the employee is very important to ensure food safety. Food poisoning bacteria may be present on the skin and in the nose of healthy people. All food handlers must therefore maintain a high standard of personal hygiene and cleanliness in order to avoid transferring food poisoning microorganisms to food. The points need to be considered by all food handlers are their health status and personal cleanliness. First, we will discuss about the health status. Personnel known or suspected to be suffering from or to be carrier of a disease or illness likely to be transmitted through food shall not be allowed to enter into any food handling area. Food business shall develop system whereby any person so affected shall immediately report illness or symptoms of illness to the management, and medical examination of a food handler shall be carried out apart from the periodic checkups if clinically or epidemiologically indicated. Arrangements shall be made to get the food handlers, employees of the establishment, medically examined once in a year to ensure that they are free from any infectious, contagious and other communicable diseases. A record of these examinations signed by a registered medical practitioner shall be maintained for inspection purpose. The factory staff shall be compulsorily inoculated against the energetic group of diseases once a year, and a record towards that shall be kept for inspection. In case of an epidemic, all workers to be vaccinated irrespective of the yearly vaccination. Then the second point is personal cleanliness of the employees. Food handlers shall maintain a high degree of personal cleanliness. The food business shall provide to all food handlers with adequate and suitable clean protective clothing, head covering, face masks, gloves and footwear, and the food business shall ensure that the food handlers at work wear only clean protective clothes, head covering and footwear every day. Food handlers with any cut or wound shall not come in direct contact with food or food contact surfaces. Food handlers shall always wash their hands with soap and clean potable water, disinfect their hands and then dry with hand dryer or clean cloth towel or disposable paper at the beginning of food handling activities, immediately after using the toilet and after handling raw food or any contaminated material, tools, equipment or work surface, where this could result in contamination of other food items. Food handlers engaged in food handling activities should avoid smoking, spitting, chewing or eating, sneezing or coughing over any food, whether protected or unprotected food, and in food preparation and food service areas. The food handlers should trim their nails periodically and do not encourage or practice unhygienic means while handling food. Persons working directly with and handling raw materials or food products shall maintain high standards of personal cleanliness at all times. They shall not smoke, spit, eat or drink in areas of rooms where raw materials and food products are handled or stored. Avoid certain hand habits, for example, like scratching nose, running finger through hair, rubbing eyes, ears and mouth, scratching beard, scratching parts of bodies, etc. They are potentially hazardous when associated with handling food products and might lead to food contamination through the transfer of bacteria from the employee to product during its preparation. When unavoidable, hands should be effectively washed before resuming work after such actions. Now we learn about hand washing. Hands must be washed before working, before preparing food, after going to toilets, after handling raw foods, after licking fingers, coughing, sneezing, eating, drinking or smoking, after touching ears, nose, hair, mouth or other bare body parts, after touching pimples or sores, after handling waste, that is kitchen waste or any other waste, after carrying out cleaning duties, after changing soiled clothes, after handling animals, after any other unhygienic practices. Now we learn about hand care. Keep fingernails short and clean. Cover all wounds or cuts on hands or arms completely with bright colored waterproof wound strip. Wear disposable gloves if there is a wound on hands. Change both gloves and wound strip regularly. Then we learn about hygiene with regard to clothing and appearance. Uniforms and aprons or clothes should be clean at the beginning of work shift, and they should wear hat or hairnet. They should avoid wearing jewelry while handling and preparing food. Avoid using strong perfumes after shaves and do not wear uniforms, aprons outside the food preparation area. Then we learn about personal hygiene practices while handling food. While handling food, avoid touching nose, mouth, hair and skin during food preparation, and do not smoke in food premises. Do not cough or sneeze directly onto food. Wash hands after coughing or sneezing. Wash hands after blowing nose. Use disposable tissues to wipe hands. Then we learn about the infection. Food handlers should be free from any illness or infection such as gastroenteritis or flu, etc. They should cease working and report to the manager when feeling illness. Now, another important aspect of hygiene in food industries is food plant hygiene. In this food plant hygiene, the first one is raw material storage, whether refrigerated and non-refrigerated. All raw materials should be free from insect and rodent infestation. They should be free of contamination from other sources, for example, like birds, moisture, mold, etc. If bulk floor handling and storage is in use, then hose couplings inside and outside plant should be adequately protected from rodents, cleaned, repaired and kept in good condition. Dust collectors or ventilation bags at top of the bulk tank should be clean and insect free. If system contains inspection ports, they should be free from contamination. The microbial load of all the food items like raw fruits and vegetables, liquid milk, meat, eggs, flour, cereal grains, etc. should be within the acceptable limits at receiving as well as during the storage in the raw material store. Depending on the nature of the food, adequate facilities should be available for storing refrigerated or frozen foods, monitoring food temperatures and controlling ambient temperatures and humidity to ensure the microbiological safety and suitability of food. In case of grain storage, fumigation should be done at regular intervals to ensure the absence of any microbiological and pest activity. Swabs can be taken from crates, tanks in which the material is kept and stored to check their microbiological suitability for the purpose and tested. Then hygiene with regard to manufacturing area in the food industries. All pieces of food equipment, that is pieces of food contact equipment like dough mixers, conveyors, rounders, dough dividers, racks, proofing equipments, oven, rollers, slicers, sifters, pasteurizer, homogenizer, retort, bottling unit, pulper, filtering screens, mixing vats, all these should be cleaned, repaired and kept in good condition. All equipments and their surroundings should be free from evidence of rodent or insect activity. Temperature of proofing equipment, ovens, retort, heat exchangers and cooling areas should be maintained. Equipment should be cleaned in place wherever possible before use. All vapor producing cooking equipment such as retort, ovens, grills and fryers should be equipped with ventilation and an approved automatic extinguishing system to prevent unnecessary condensation in the working area which may harbor microorganisms. Utensils like spoons, beaters, pans, bowls, trays, spatulas, etc. should be sanitized after every lot manufactured. Utensils and equipment washing facilities should be clean and adequate. Working area as well as the outside premises should be free from spilled powders or liquids, trash, etc., which may attract or harbor pests, rodent or microorganisms. In slaughterhouse, diseased animal should be condemned and it should not be allowed to move further in the process. In meat processing units, carcass from diseased animal or with any internal bruises, boils, etc. should be removed from the process and be disposed of accordingly. Swabs of machine, working tables, utensils, food contact surfaces should be taken at regular intervals to ensure their microbial safety for food use. Air contamination should be adjusted by checking the microbial quality of air. Antiseptic and disinfectant food bath should be provided at the entrance of plant. Then hygienic practices during packaging and storage of finished product. Packaging material generally pouches, films, laminates, cans, glass and PET bottles, closures, jars, cardboard boxes, all these should be kept under hygienic conditions in a room intended for that purpose. Packaging material like bottles, closures, etc. should be sanitized before use. All the products should be labeled accordingly to the Food Labeling Act. Immediately after packaging and proper labeling, the product should be placed in the rooms provided for storage under required temperature and humidity conditions to prevent any spoilage. Temperature and relative humidity of the storage area should be maintained to optimum required level. Pest control. Pests may contaminate food and cause foodborne illness. The pest control program should be developed to eliminate pests and prevent pests from infesting food premises. An effective pest control program should be able to prevent access, deny harborage, and eradicate any pest present in the industry. Then certain important preventive measures which can be followed in the food industries for safety of the food. First one is store food and supplies properly by covering them properly, storing them at least 15 cm by 6 inches of the floor and 15 cm by 6 inches away from the walls. Store them at low humidity, that is 50% or less. Apply first in first out system. Remove cartons, newspapers, etc. that may attract and harbor pests. Store and remove garbage properly and regularly. Keep refuse bins covered. Keep garbage in sealed plastic bags and inside tightly covered refuse bins. Clean up spillages of food immediately. Keep toilets clean and hygienic. Another important aspect in maintenance of hygiene and quality of food in industry is inspection. Inspect both outside and inside of premises. Check incoming food and supplies for signs of pest. Example, any pest is harbored inside the packaging of food and supplies. Elimination. Elimination is another important aspect. Use chemical, physical or biological means, example rodent traps where there are signs of pest. Japer or insecticulator to capture and kill flying insects. Ensure jumpers are not above or within 3 meters of food preparation or storage area. Avoid spraying insecticide over food preparation surfaces. Hire a professional pest control company when necessary. Then waste disposal. Waste can be regarded as any item of foods, ingredients, packaging materials, etc., which is not suitable for further use and intended to be disposed of. Waste should be controlled carefully since it presents a risk of contamination of food. Waste disposable bins should be placed near the working area of food preparation rooms and positioned conveniently to operating staff. Waste disposable bins should be clearly distinguishable from other storage bins. A defined area should be allocated for the storage of waste pending disposal. When food waste is removed from food preparation area pending disposable, it must be placed in a tightly covered waste storage bin. Plastic liners should be used in waste disposable and storage bins. Waste disposable and storage bins should be emptied when full or on a regular basis. Waste disposable bins should be cleaned and sanitized daily and placed upside down and off the floor to drain overnight. Then another important aspect in the food industry is staff training. Staff training is another important aspect in food industries. Training offers food handlers a better understanding of how food can become contaminated and how foodborne illness can be avoided through proper food handling procedures. Each food business must decide what training their food handlers need by identifying the area of their work most likely to affect food hygiene and safety. Examples of basic knowledge of food safety are main factors contributing to outbreaks of foodborne illness, temperature control of potential hazardous foods, proper ways of using equipment, example the skill of using thermometer, knowledge of handling cooking and storage equipment. Examples of basic knowledge of food hygiene are also includes skill and significance of maintaining good personal hygiene practices, knowledge and skills of cleaning and sanitizing, pest control. It is a good practice for a business to identify the training needs of each staff member. It is also a good practice to keep training records of every staff member in the food business. Training needs should be reviewed on a regular basis and should be assessed against the role and responsibilities, existing skills, experience and previous training of the staff. Therefore, students, today we have learned about the importance of cleanliness because it is a major factor in preventing foodborne illness in food business and at household level also. Everything that touches food should be clean because bacteria are everywhere. Cleanliness is a major factor in preventing foodborne illness. By keeping everything clean that comes in contact with food, consumers can be assured they are helping to do their part to be food safe. Thank you, students.